Compton is an interesting place. People are very color conscious in those neighborhoods. Certain gangs, that's what they're known for. That's like wearing a flag, you know.
Martin had a dream. Kendrick have a dream.
Seahawks cornerback Richard Sherman grew up in Compton, California, a city located within the southern part of Los Angeles. During his childhood, the area was notorious for its active gang culture and violence.
You see red, it's like, you know, you're kind of wearing that to make a statement. I don't know of a neighborhood where I could wear whatever I wanted.
All my life I want money and power.
Us growing up, we had to deal with, you know, our peers being involved in gangs, children selling drugs, seeing a lot of things that young children shouldn't see.
What's one of the worst things that you witnessed in your area growing up?
I've seen a couple bodies, the drug use. I mean, I've seen some pretty terrible things, but I think it's kind of just hardened me, you know, to pain.
That pain was balanced with the love Sherman had at home. His parents played a huge role both in their kids' lives and others.
My mom, she always welcomed people into our homes, you know, like they were family. We'd have a house full of people, you know, 20, 30 kids, and she'd feed all of them. It always felt like there was a home away from home for anybody who needed it.
I love children, and I embrace them and try to help rear them in the right direction as I would do my own.
The only criteria was that when you were with us, you wasn't a gang member.
Your dad has a bullet wound scar that he showed you. Describe what you first thought and the impact that it had on you when he showed you that.
When I was younger, I used to think it was pretty cool. I mean, you're like, man, my dad's a freaking warrior, man, because the bullet wound was near his heart.
Some guys pulled up in a car with tinted windows and basically tried to kill us all. And I took a couple of bullets to the chest, showed that to Richard and Branton just to show them that being in the wrong place, it'll happen.
As you get older and you start to understand what's going on in your surroundings better, you start to think he could have easily not been here and life would be a whole lot different without him.
But the one in front of the gun lives forever.
Sherman's parents were so respected in their neighborhood that local gang members kept Sherman and his brother Branton away from the violent Compton gang culture.
We took care of a lot of kids in the neighborhood. That was their way of showing their thanks to us, was to be our eyes and ears in the neighborhood.
But while Sherman and his family felt protected from the violence that surrounded the area, others close to them were not so fortunate. In 2005, during his freshman year at Stanford, Sherman's best friend, Marcus Peters, was shot and killed.
It was just devastating to tell him that. I literally thought I was gonna have to go up there and get my child, because he took it pretty hard.
He got killed at home, minding his own business, not doing anything to anybody, unarmed, not wearing any crazy colors, and they had to cut it short. And you know, that's real frustrating, but it's one of those things you gotta live with.
It's intercepted by Richard Sherman. He's going down the sideline. He has followers, and not just on Twitter. Touchdown, Seahawks!
Today, Sherman takes full advantage to give back to the youth in his hometown, hoping to help change the image of Compton.
I think the people who are there are trying to change the image from the gangsters, so I'm trying to do my best, and so are the other people, of making these kids more aware and giving them the resources they need to be successful.